Now that we have attached the motor to our longboard, it's time to give it some power. For that, we need a battery pack. So in this video, let's make a battery pack for our longboard along with a 3D printed case for it. So without any further ado, let's get this thing rolling. This project is sponsored by Soldron. I have been using their products for a really long time and never had any complaints. Many people have even shared that their 25-year-old soldering iron works till this date, which is fantastic. I am also doing a giveaway in collaboration with Soldron, and in that you can get a chance to win their completely brand new digitally adjustable soldering iron. You can find the more details about the giveaway and the Soldron, link is in the video description. For building the battery pack, we mainly have two different options. Number 1, lithium polymer cells. I won't be using this as they are quite expensive and dangerous as well if not handled properly. On the other hand, we have lithium ion cells. They are relatively cheaper, and the best part is that you can even use old ones recycled from old laptop batteries. I have a video on that, you can check that out. Before building the battery pack, I started by measuring the size of the skateboard as I was building a 6S 3P battery pack. I used this tiny little black spacer to hold the cells together. They are specifically designed for building the battery packs, and they are easy to use. Here I am building two sets of battery pack with 9 cells in each. But how I will connect them, I will explain you in a bit. Now for connections, I will be using this 0.15mm thick nickel strips. I just measured out the appropriate distance between two cells, and then I used my cutters to snip it. After which I used my DIY battery spot welder and did two sets of weld on each side of the cell. But if needed, you can do more. Also, it's not mandatory to use a spot welder for building a battery pack. You can even use a soldering iron and just few wires to solder all of this together. But it heats up the cells, which can be dangerous. So I will recommend to stick to spot welding, but if you don't have a spot welder, don't worry, you can always use soldering iron. Now before soldering any further, I fired up the Fusion 360 software and designed this case for the battery pack. Here I had to split the design in two pieces so it can fit on my printer's bed. I also made this few mounting holes in the design itself so it can mount easily. Along with that, I also made this case for the mounting ESC on the skateboard. After which I just used Cura to slice it and then printed it using my printer. In total, it took me about 18 hours to print all 3 parts, but it was totally worth it. But if you don't have a 3D printer, don't worry, you can use some kind of a box to make something similar. Once the print was complete, I removed all the support material and then just used some super glue to fix the two-part design. So we have two sets of battery pack over here. One set over here has 6 cells in series, and these 3 cells in series. So we should measure 24 volts over here and 12 volts over here. Same goes for this set. So let's first measure that. This one is 24 volts, as you can see. This one shows 12 volts. This one also shows 12 volts. And finally, this one shows 24 volts.
So when we are done, we will connect these three cells and these three cells in series. So we have 24 volts battery pack, something like this. Right now I'm just connecting it like this, but we will later on connect using some wires. So now we have another 24 volt battery pack. So when we are done, finally, we will have three battery packs of 24 volts, and each of this battery pack is capable of 2000 mAh. So when we connect these three battery pack in series, we will have about 6000 mAh of power. So that should be plenty for me, but you can always increase the number of cells if you want more mAh.
Now here starts the tricky part. Firstly, I soldered the two 3S battery packs which I showed earlier in series to form a 6S battery pack. Then I added wires to all the cells which will be used for balanced charging, as I do not plan to add a BMS in this build. It looks messy over here, but it's really simple. I will recommend you to watch my How to Build a Battery Pack video if you want more explanation. Then it was just a matter of connecting individual wires together to form a single balanced lead. Now that was complete, I added some 2.5 square millimeter wires to connect all 24 volts lead together so they are in parallel. With that being said, our battery pack was complete. Then I used some 2 component epoxy to glue XT60 and the balance lead for the charging. After which I did this kind of a joint, so we have 2 24 volt lead. One of them goes to XT60 plug in the battery case we just glued, and the other one goes to another XT60 which we will use later on. Now it's time for mounting the battery pack on the longboard. For which I simply place the battery pack in its position and then use tip of the screwdriver to mark the holes. After which firstly I use 2mm thick drill bit to drill the pilot holes so wood doesn't crack. Now I used a 4mm thick drill bit to expand the holes. And here is a small tip for you guys. First of all, use 6mm thick drill bit and drill just about halfway from the top. And then when you use flathead screws, they will be completely flush with the surface. Then I just repeated the same procedure for mounting case of the ESC, and now use an extension cable with T connector on the one end which connects to the ESC, and the other end goes to the XT60 on the battery pack which we left earlier. At the end, only thing left to do was just add some M4 nuts and bolt and tighten up everything. And don't forget to use thread lock. Once that was complete, this project was almost complete because we still need to work on a radio controller, which is a topic for another video. Until then, don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and don't forget about the giveaway, and I will see you guys in the next one.